Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Driveway Concert 5, A Baroque Sandwich. My name is Marcia Henry Liebenow, and I'm honored today to share the stage, or my driveway, with Julie Herring and Molly Wilson. Everyone will introduce themselves later, but we will begin the concert sandwich with music by Béla Bartók, who is not a Baroque composer. Bartók is a Hungarian composer, pianist, and ethnomusicologist who lived from 1881 to 1945 and is one of the most celebrated early 20th century composers. During the early part of his career, he traveled to various small villages in his homeland and recorded townspeople singing and playing instruments. And he collected a treasure trove of Eastern European folk music, which became the basis of many of his later compositions. Bartók wrote a collection of 44 violin duets initially intended to be used for teaching young students, but these pieces are quite popular with all violinists. All of the songs and dances included in these duos are based on the folk music he collected from various Eastern European countries, but his personal stamp was in the harmonies and the rhythmic freedom he used in some of the duets. Each duet is very short and many have descriptive titles. We have chosen 7 of them to play for you today. This is with Julie. We will give you the titles for each 2 so you can keep track. So between each 2, we'll turn our page and clothespin it down and give you the next title. So it's we love the applause, but why don't you wait until the very end before you applaud? So here are our Bartók duets. The first 2 are called Play Song and Ruthenian Song. The next one is entitled Pillow Dance, and we'll play Burlesque after that. Thank you. Might be very appropriate very soon in the summer. It's called Dance of the Mosquito. And it's followed by Teasing Song. The last one we'll play for you this afternoon is called The Bagpipe. Series of driveway concerts, which I started in early April, I wanted to pay tribute to the Peoria Bach Festival that typically takes place each summer in the early June. This year, like everything else, the Peoria Bach Festival was canceled. I was scheduled to play a chamber music recital at the festival this year, so I decided to do a driveway concert to honor the Bach Festival with some delightful Baroque compositions. Our next selections on the program are the Baroque Sandwich Filling. Johann Sebastian Bach was a German composer from the Baroque era. Although he was admired by his contemporaries primarily as an outstanding harpsichordist, organist, and expert on organ building, Bach is now generally regarded as one of the greatest composers of all time and is celebrated as the creator of Brandenburg Concertos, the Well-Tempered Clavier, Mass in B minor, many, many instrumental works, choral works, secular and sacred pieces. And Bach at the time was able to bring everything together, survey and bring together the principal styles, forms, and traditions that had developed during the preceding generations, and because, by virtue of a synthesis, he enriched all of those styles. Today we will play three of Bach's two-part inventions. In their original form, the inventions are a collection of short keyboard works. We found a set of them arranged for two violins. Each movement is very imitative in composition style, so it is very conversational. For the three Bach inventions we chose, Molly, Julie, and I will rotate parts. I'd like to invite them to each introduce themselves now.
Hi, I'm Molly. I recently graduated from DePaul University School of Music with my master's degree, and for my bachelor's degree, I attended Bradley University, where I studied just recently, since moving back to Peoria this June, I have begun teaching with the Youth Music Illinois Suzuki School of Music.
Hi, I'm Julie, and I went to Bradley for my undergrad. I graduated in 2016, but I studied with Marcia there all 4 years, and now I live in Hartford, Connecticut, which is where I did my master's degree, and I'm currently working on my Doctor of Musical Arts degree there. And I'm also the concertmaster of the Connecticut Valley Symphony Orchestra, and I teach private lessons in the Hartford area.
And you probably know I'm Marcia Henry Liebenow, and I'm concertmaster of the Peoria Symphony Orchestra, and I teach violin, viola, and chamber music at Bradley. And I'm in a trio called the Concordia String Trio, and typically doing all kinds of music festivals, but this summer it's right in our driveway, so. So here is the first of the Bach two-part inventions. Thank you.
The next piece in the portion of our Baroque sandwich is continuing with the Baroque theme here with Arcangelo Corelli's Trio Sonata Opus 3, Number 2. Arcangelo Corelli was an Italian Baroque violinist and composer, and he was also the teacher of Vivaldi, who you may have also heard of before. This piece is in four movements. The first movement is slow, second movement is fast, third movement is slow, and the fourth movement is fast again. So if you'd like, you can hold your applause until the end of the four movements. In its original format, this piece was for two violins and a lower bass instrument, or a continuo. So Marcia will actually be playing the cello part for this piece. And this is arranged by Marcia's father, Percy Hall. So I hope you enjoy this Trio Sonata by Corelli.
The next piece on the program is by Jean-Marie Leclerc, who was a French Baroque composer. He kind of developed a French style like Corelli did for the Italians in the Baroque era. And this is a duo sonata. It's part of a set of six sonatas that he composed for two violins, and it was published in 1730. And Leclerc was born in 1697 and he died in 1764. There's three movements. They're in a structure of fast, slow, fast. And it's in the key of A major, so it's nice and happy.
Thank you.
Well, now we're back to the bread of the sandwich with a non-Baroque composer, which is also our last piece of the day. Andreas Makris was a Greek-American composer and violinist born in 1930. He was composer in residence for the National Symphony Orchestra in Washington, D.C. for many years, working with a number of highly esteemed conductors. He composed about 100 works for orchestra, chamber ensembles, and solo instruments. And he was a recipient of many prestigious awards, including a National Endowment for the Arts grant, an ASCAP award, a Fulbright scholarship, and citations from the Greek government. Makris was also a member of the first violin section of the National Symphony Orchestra for 28 years, and previously held positions with the Dallas Symphony and the St. Louis Symphony. The piece we will end our concert with today is the last movement of Makris' Duet for Two Violins, and it has a very interesting subtitle, Little Milton on the Beach. Milton was his son, and his inspiration for this duet. This movement is a lively dance in 7/8 time and reflects his Greek heritage.
I'm dropping some notes
here. I just wanted to thank you again for listening, and for those of you who are here in the real live audience. I especially want to thank Julie and Molly for participating in this concert with me today. If you know of people who didn't get to hear the concert, just check it out. It's going to be posted on my timeline and for public viewing, so you can come back and catch it or listen again. But as a teacher, it's just super great for me to say that, you know, when my students go off and become, I mean, they were great musicians before they graduated, but now it's just fun to see them in the real world and to collaborate with them. So it's just really a special treat. And we are all looking forward to the 2021 Peoria Bach Festival next June. So otherwise, we'll post information as soon as I have it all figured out about my next driveway concert venture. So stay tuned, but thank you again for coming.